Hey, what's up, guys? It's the Apache from Hard Mode. Gonna be playing a little Wolf Among Us episode 4. As you could kind of tell, I kind of went through the episode already. I had a video up where I thought I was making, you know, all the good choices, but, you know, something just didn't seem like I did things the right way, I guess you would say. And a lot of my choices seemed to kind of collide with the Beards video, so I decided to give it a little extra playthrough for you guys, and be sure you know, get that better story in there. Oh yeah.
Bullets are a nasty business. The silver slug deformed and shredded on impact.
He'll be okay, though. He'll be okay?
His internal organs are positively riddled. If I don't extract every single scrap of silver, he's liable to suffer some long-term toxicosis. Easy there. Try not to move. We can't keep meeting this way, old boy. I figured I'd be done before you were conscious, but there's little I can do for the pain.
Swinehart, how bad is it?
Not the worst I've seen, but damn near it. I must say, you're testing even my skills here.
Please, Bigby, don't move it. Doctor.
Look, I'm a bit engaged saving his life at the moment, but if the fractured extremity concerns him that much, he can set it himself. Not bad. That'll do, I suppose. He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this. He didn't listen to me before. Maybe he'll listen to you.
I don't know about that.
Well, he should. There are limits to what even I can do.
It's not like I asked for this shit to happen.
Yes, but it's not like you actively discouraged it either. Excuse me, Miss White, but perhaps it'd be better if you gave me a few minutes to finish with him.
I think I should stay, at least until he's out of the woods.
Believe me, Bigby couldn't be in better hands, and I need the space to work, so if you wouldn't mind, we'd appreciate the headroom.
Don't worry, Snow. I'll be okay.
We'll be done in a moment. Just please, give us the time.
Hey, Doc, how much longer?
Colin, leave him be.
It's finished when it's finished.
Cause I once watched a vet sew a turtle together in 10 minutes flat.
Colin, you're not even supposed to be here right now.
Oh, really? Where am I supposed to be? I'm here to take care of my friend.
Could you please not distract the doctor while he has my chest cut open?
Yes, that would be helpful. There. All done.
Great.
This isn't a habit you should keep to, having visits with me. And, well, this time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart, and the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue. Miss White, he'll be fine for light duty, if he can figure out what that means.
He knows what it means. It's just been an unusual couple of days.
I know, But please, don't give him the excuse. His body will eventually give out. Take care of him. Please.
I will. He'll need rest, I assume?
Sleep, mostly. Just keep watch. And make sure he doesn't get into further altercations.
Snow has enough to deal with, Swinehart. I can take care of myself.
Clearly. Anyways, guard against, as they say. Miss White? Sheriff? Colin.
Swiney?
So, how do you, feel?
It's Bigby, Snow. He'll be okay. Hell, I've seen him take worse.
Not as good as can be expected, I think.
So, not well, then.
I'm glad you're not dead. You stopped breathing, you know, when you passed out or died, I guess. It kind of scared the hell out of me. I've never seen you like that. And when Swinehart arrived...
Snow, I'd never leave you.
Yeah, you were really fucked up, man. You'll look like when you take an action figure and bend its limbs the wrong way.
Colin...
I'm just saying, I was worried about him is all. The guy hasn't had a night's rest in days.
Well, I'll get some rest when this whole thing is done.
What whole thing? What's even happening out there? I mean, do you guys have like a plan or something? And who should I be asking? Should I be worried about the Crooked Man taking over?
The Crooked Man, Bloody Mary, the Tweedles... This is bigger than what I thought it was.
Yeah. The Crooked Man came out of the shadows for a reason. For him to attack us so blatantly like that. He either feels invincible or desperate.
Well, if those are my two options, I don't think I'd pick desperate.
What do you mean?
You traded Crane to save Bigby. I'm just saying, that's not exactly something you do when you're playing with house money.
Yeah, thanks, Snow. For all that back there.
No problem.
Thanks? You're not pissed that Crane's flown the coop? Or that the Crooked Man thinks he's got Snow under his thumb?
We're all mad about it, Colin.
What else could Snow do? If she didn't hand him over, my ass would be down the witching well. Crane still would have been taken.
Okay, I'll take your word for it.
All I care about right now is... Just what does the Crooked Man want out of this? I thought he was just a loan shark, but clearly he's operating in other circles. It can't just be about Crane, right? Getting him out of town? Is this all about the murders? Crane can't be useful to him anymore. So what could this have to do with Faith and Lily?
This is about those girls, and it'll always be about those girls. Nothing will change that.
We'll see. The Crooked Man. Declared war against us last night. At least that's what I thought when it happened. But now I see this war has been going on for years. We just haven't noticed it because our way of doing things is broken. We need to do things the right way.
What does that mean, the right way?
What do you think I mean?
I don't know, but it suspiciously sounds like your way. Bigby's the one on the front lines. You can't give him a leash. He doesn't work that way.
A little restraint and thought behind things will never hurt anyone, Colin.
Look, I know things haven't gone great recently, but we're still doing our best.
That's not good enough. So, starting now, we do everything cut and dried. By the book, straight as an arrow.
Pure as driven snow.
I'm not saying I'm the arbiter of...
Sure you're not.
This town has enough monsters. What happened last night, what you turned into, it can't happen again.
We need monsters. To fight monsters.
Colin, if I really believed that we needed him to lose his flippin' mind at a moment's notice, then that would mean I'd lost all faith in our ability to help this town. Just let that side of you be done, okay?
I'll do better. We'll do better. We have to be better than them, or what's the point?
Right, exactly. Thank you. Look, I'm sorry that I have to bring all this up, but I think it's important. Look, Bigby, I care about how this is done just as much as I care about it getting done.
So for that, you want to give him a handicap? Like the bad guys will worry if shit gets sloppy. Everybody wants Bigby to smile and shave and take a shower now and then. Hell, I'm practically the president of the Bigby Don't Be Such a Dick Club. But this is the wrong fucking time to put shackles on him.
Well, at least someone understands. Thanks, Colin.
He'll get the job done. Just let him do it.
I'm going to let you do it, okay? It's just that now that I'm deputy mayor, I need your respect. And this situation has to end.
What situation?
All unglamored fables starting today have to go and stay at the farm.
Oh, give me a fucking break. Are you gonna let her talk to me like that?
It's been the rule for a reason, Colin. And Bigby knows it's for the best of the town. It keeps everybody out of trouble.
That's not gonna happen.
Yes, it will.
It's an impossible rule to enforce, Snow. You really expect to round up every talking cat and raven in town?
There's not that many stragglers left. Except the one or two you make excuses for. Wolf's residence.
That's rude.
Oh, Buffkin, what is it? Okay, I'll let him know. Thanks. Guess who's waiting in your office right now? Narissa.
Narissa?
That broad from the pudding and pie?
Yes. Apparently, she told Buffkin that she has something she needs to talk to you about. But that she'll only tell you. And what do you think that could be?
Bigby's got an admirer. You always do well with the, disenfranchised.
She knows something. She's helped me a little with the case. Maybe she has something else.
Maybe she does. I should get back to the business office. I've left Buffkin alone for too long taking calls. And I should probably change out of these clothes. Consider the discussion tabled, but not over. Let me know when you're done with Narissa.
Aye, aye, Captain. She's a piece of work. Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? I mean, she seemed real serious about it, but I can still hang out here.
Look, maybe a few will get sent up, but you're my friend, Colin. I wouldn't do that to you. Don't worry about it.
Thanks, Bigby.
Hi, Sheriff.
Hi, Narissa. Have a seat.
Are you okay? You didn't look good last night. I wasn't sure you'd be, you know, around.
Well, let's just say I've been better.
Huff and Puffs. Not many people smoke those. Thanks.
So what is it you wanted to talk to me about? I know what you did for me, sending me to the open arms. And I think you want to help me again.
There's not a lot that I can talk about. You know that.
So that spell Crane was trying to break. It's not just while you're at work, huh?
What I mean is, I don't want to waste your time, but I don't want you wasting your own time either.
Back in the dressing room, at the pudding and pie, I told you what I was looking for, and you found a way to tell me. You sent me to the open arms. Maybe that'll work again?
You can try. I just... Go ahead. It might work.
You're here because the Crooked Man just sent Crane to the bottom of my list of worries. And you have something you want to say about that, right?
These lips are sealed. If I could answer you just like that, I wouldn't have had to make that appointment with you.
No, I guess not.
Sometimes, we have to find our way through life on our own, grasping and fumbling in the dark. I used to have friends to help me find my way, but now they're gone, and I don't know what to do. Is this making any sense?
Are you trying to say something about Faith and Lily?
What I'm saying is friends matter. And I don't have any left. So I hope you're looking after yours. Are you? Look around you.
Are you telling me my friends are involved?
I'm sorry. I thought I could do this. I need you to know I want to help, but
your lips are sealed.
I'm sorry if I'm wasting your time. I thought I knew how to say it.
Ribbons. Faith wore one too, huh?
Do you like it? Hmm? Do you?
It is beautiful. That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it? Break it. Is there something I can do about it?
No! Lips are sealed!
What?
You can't! Just stay back! You can't do that!
Slow down. It's all right. I'm not gonna do anything.
Please, don't.
Okay. I get it. So the ribbons, if you take them off...
If anyone finds out I came here...
That's probably Snow.
Listen, Sheriff, can you keep this conversation between us? I could be in a lot of trouble. I shouldn't be talking to you. Please.
I'm gonna have to tell Snow. She has to know about the ribbons.
If you have to, just don't tell anyone else.
Sorry, I just need to talk to the sheriff for a moment. Please excuse us.
1 minute.
I might have a new lead for you, but I don't know how solid it is. Beauty and Beast called the office just now. They said they wanted to talk to you about something. I wonder if they've heard about Crane.
Thank you for listening, Sheriff. You should go on to your next business. I don't think you'll be wasting your time.
Wait, you don't have to go. That was abrupt.
It's one way to send a message.
What did she tell you? I didn't mean to rush her out. Did you get anything from her?
She couldn't really say anything. The magic that Crane was talking about, it's in the ribbon.
And you can't take the ribbon off, or...
It's how Faith and Lily died.
Okay then. Good work. So, about Beauty and Beast, do you think there's something to it? Is this the right place to look? What could they know about the Crooked Man?
That's what Nerissa was doing, telling us to go there. I think she made it as clear as she could have.
You know, Beauty came to me a while back. She was looking for financial assistance. I told her there was nothing I could do, and she said that meant she'd have to go somewhere else. Bigby, you don't think she meant that she was going to go to the Crooked Man, do you?
That would explain why they called.
We need to solve this before something else happens. Who knows what? I have other matters to attend to.
And you didn't want to tell me what you were into either.
Good reason. Look what happened.
So that's back on me now. I thought we agreed that was...
Oh. What do you want?
Well, you're just going around knocking on doors?
You called, right? Or, was it Beauty?
Why would I call you?
Listen, I've had a shitty night.
Do you think you're the only one?
And I really don't want to deal with the runaround. Snow said you called and wanted to talk to me.
Well, I didn't call. Must have been Beauty. She's been surprising me a lot lately.
Can I?
So have you, Bigby. Yet, with all the sneaking around and secrets, somehow I'm still the bad guy in this. I've had to hear about it all night long from her.
Who is it? Who's there? Beast?
If you don't want to talk, can you just get Beauty for me?
I don't know. Is it safe to turn my back? It's your pal, Bigby.
Hi, Bigby. Please excuse us for just a minute. Can I talk to you in private?
Yes, let's.
I guess I really do have the smallest apartment in the Woodlands.
I can already tell you're going to make a problem out of this.
What's he doing here? We don't need to bring him into this.
Beast.
I just don't think we can trust him. Not after the way he went behind my back. And then you run and call him again?
Well, I trust him.
Of course you do.
Talk about living in the past.
It was one little thing. Do you want to keep fighting about that? Or do you want to try to sort this out?
All I'm saying is we can handle this on our own. You didn't have to bring him here.
We're out of money. And answers. That's why I called. We'll finish this later. But we need to talk to Bigby.
Fine. If you want to talk, we'll talk.
Sorry, it's been a long night.
Yeah, you know what they say. Centuries of marriage come with centuries of baggage.
I gotta say, your place, it looks, expensive.
What do you mean by that?
Beast!
No, really, I want to know. What are you trying to say, huh? Did you come to give us decorating tips?
Nothing. It's a nice place you got here.
Thanks, but that's really not why I called.
Snow told me you went to her for some financial help. Did you end up going to the Crooked Man?
I didn't know what else to do,
We should deal with this on our own. Bigby's just going to complicate things.
I called him here, and I want to see if he can help us out. Why are you being like this?
I'm just trying to do what's best for us.
I'd like to help you, but I can't do anything if you don't tell me what's going on.
I gotta know one thing first. What if we did have something to say about the Crooked Man? What if we talk and you don't get him? And all this comes back on us? We'd be risking a lot. We've seen what happens when you cross the Crooked Man. And I don't know if it's worth it. If you can't give us certain assurances.
I can protect you, but only if you tell me what I need to know. And that means details. No more stonewalling.
We aren't.
And just tell me what's going on here.
Look, we're used to a certain kind of lifestyle, okay? We couldn't just give that
up. We never meant for it to get like this. It's just that we had nowhere else to turn, and we got in over our heads.
There's not a lot of work out there. Who would we be if we just lived like... Let me just,
A day at the beach?
Skiing the slopes?
And we can't come to the phone right now, so leave a message at the beep and we'll get back to you as soon as...
What the fuck was that?
Don't worry about it. Probably just a wrong number. Really, I think we're one digit off from some pizza place.
Who was that? You know who that was. Don't hold out on me.
We've been getting horrible phone calls. It's the Crooked Man's people, trying to collect, and we aren't safe, even in our own home.
We owe some money.
Finally. All I care about is, how can I find the Crooked Man? Who do I talk to? Where do I go?
The Lucky Pawn. That's where I borrowed the money. The Crooked Man's behind that place. I'd overheard people talking to Jersey about loans before. So, when I needed money, that's where I went. I didn't know what to do.
Did you ever see the Crooked Man there? When you got your loan? Or just shopping?
No, never. But, come on, it's his place. And the Jersey Devil never lets you forget it. I can see now that it was a mistake, but I'm not the only one who goes there, you know. I saw the woodsman's axe there just the other day. It was in a display case.
I guess he's hit hard times, too. There's a lot of that going around.
Fucking Bloody Mary must go through there. She had Woody's axe last night, trying to chop my damn head off with it.
Maybe if you go there, you can sort some things out.
I guess I'll go check out the Lucky Pawn. If I can't track down the Crooked Man there, maybe I can make enough noise that the Crooked Man will come find me.
Hold on, Bigby. Don't go there. Sounds like you're just going to get Beauty in trouble. And... You know that butcher shop, the cut above? It's the place on Tubman Street. Same block as the baker and the candlestick maker. Well, I've been delivering packages from there for a while. The thing is, it's for the Crooked Man. And I don't think it's meat in the packages. You gotta understand, I needed work.
You have to believe us. We didn't think it would get like this.
We're decent people, Bigby.
Well, what are you delivering? What's going on there? How does this fit into the Crooked Man's operation?
I couldn't tell you, but I do know this. It's the only meat market in town that doesn't carry filet. I'm not sure how much actual butchery goes on there.
How did you get involved with this?
Johann the butcher called. He had a problem with the refrigeration unit one night. But when I finished, it was your pal Mary who showed up to pay me. She said I was reliable. She liked that. And it's the only thing I've been able to pick up, and it's still not enough. I don't want Beauty to have to work, especially not where she was.
It's Mary you deal with? Bloody Mary is there?
No, Johann is the one who hands over the packages, you know, day to day. But I've seen her around there. She gets under my skin, you know? I try to avoid her. But I don't need to tell you what she's
You're
like.
You're damn right you don't. I don't need a rundown on her reputation. If Mary works out of there, I need to look into it.
I just wanted to provide for Beauty. Give her the kind of life she deserves.
We shouldn't have to live like this, scraping to get by.
None of us should. We were royalty once. We were accustomed to a certain lifestyle. All we want is to make this place feel a little bit like home.
You wouldn't understand, Bigby.
No, probably not.
So, where are you going? If this all goes sideways, I'd like to know where it's coming from. You know that butcher shop, the cut above?
I want to know what the Crooked Man is hiding at that butcher shop.
You know, Bigby, once you show up there, word is gonna spread. There may be nothing left for you to see if you go to the Lucky Pawn after.
Well, I guess I'll find out.
Wait. I don't know what you're planning to do when you find the Crooked Man, but is there any way you could help us out?
What do you mean?
Well, maybe you can make this all just go away.
We would really appreciate it. What do you say?
Can you help us out?
I'll handle it. I'm not gonna let that crooked bastard ruin any more lives.
Oh, thank you, Bigby.
I'm sure you'll do the right thing.
Bet that's what Beast was talking about. That logo looks familiar. I've seen this before, at Antique Greenleaf's.
Bigby Wolf?
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you? You interested in a particular cut? Let's see. What do we have in stock? Let's see what we got here. Flank steak on special. New York strip. I can have some wild boar in tomorrow if you like. Sirloin, ribs, roast,
tongue. Got some tongue here.
I know Bloody Mary hangs around here. I want to talk to her.
I don't know what you mean. What you see is what you get. Just meat. You'll find anything else. We just, we do more wholesale and meat packing than walk-up service. I'd like to help you. Really, I would. But there's nothing here.
So you don't mind if I take a look around?
I guess not. Sheriff, Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see. Shit.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out. Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They're gonna kill me. Oh God, she is gonna fucking kill me.
He's gonna get me killed. Things I do.
Huh? Please, please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby, what happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please, please don't kill me.
Listen, just calm the fuck down, okay? I just want some answers.
Okay, I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johan, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment. Easy, even when they got down a hook in the deep freeze.
They? Do you mean Mary? Bloody Mary?
This isn't my shop anymore. That crew took it from me a long time ago.
Crew?
Fuck. The Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, D and Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me, took over my storage and delivery a long time ago. All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I'd let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear. And I don't want to know.
It's all right. I believe you. Calm down.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when.
Shh. Is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
Damn it. You can't act like you're forced into this and then turn around and help them. Still be here if you hadn't flipped that switch out there.
I had to. Huh. You come in here making trouble for me, but you only give a shit now because the Crooked Man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back?
Well, I'm here now. I'm gonna sort this all out. this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff. Chains? Who's getting chained up here?
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
Looks like math or something. Shit. Is everybody on here?
Do you know anything about this?
I don't know. Well, a lot of fables out there need a lot of things.
These are raw materials for making magic. Auntie Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables, getting magic from him. Business is booming. He's got all he needs. The raw materials and the slave labor to process them. And with all this gear, looks like they could make just about any kind of magic. A lot of it. And it's pretty clear why.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Doing it like this, it's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
It's the pudding and pie girls with the ribbons. Whoever he's got in here in these chains, he's enslaving fables. My watch. People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
That fucker, Crane, knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? Finding the Crooked Man is so fucking important. Why don't you ask your boss?
Snow?
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got some way. That's right. It was that creepy magic mirror with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the Crooked Man that way. And leave me alone. Yeah, with stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office. Can't you just vaporize anyone who gives you trouble? Do it right from your living room. Smoking cigarettes with your feet up. Well, if they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it. The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn. If I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on! Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me? Huh? Do you really think this is gonna be all right? Of all this stuff in here, I do know one thing. That's his icon, his symbol. What kind of a guy uses a torture device as his icon? The kind of guy who isn't gonna be understanding about Bigby Wolf showing himself in. So tell me this. What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary.
Report to the business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just
gonna... my fucking
Jack,
system.
What the fuck is going on?
But you,
I'm
you're the guy who
just gonna...
Sure.
I'm the guy to keep shit in order. You know. And that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen from my...
So get the fuck out of my sight. Hit the bricks. See you later.
Hey, what's going on here?
What the fucking hell?
Christ. And this fucking guy, too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna... You piece of shit.
Back it up, Jersey. You're dealing with me now.
You got here fast. Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Where's my axe? Who'd you give it to?
You follow me here all the way from Battery fucking Park? Just so I can prove to you that your axe isn't here.
Trust me, you do not want to go there.
And what if I do?
Back off, dog. I just want what's mine. My axe.
You talk big, but I don't think you got the stones to back it up. Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun? You ain't so tough. You know what? I'm just gonna... You fucking mother... Oh, motherfucker!
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. Had useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror.
Where's the crooked man? How can I find him?
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump. Fucking bitch.
Why just tell me this? Are you trying to rush me out of here?
I'm trying to make a point, dog. You can have all the information you fucking want. It's not gonna help you when the time comes. And that time, it's a-coming. Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat. No time for traveler's checks, huh? That sick piece of... The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you can do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the Crooked Man wanted them dead. That's all it takes. So you can roar smash the place up. Shit. You can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you? Because he ain't in your town. You're in his. And he sure as shit is ready for you.
Out of smoke? Thanks. Shitty brand.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to... Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
All right, go do it then.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
You gonna be all right?
You know me.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment, please.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
Buffkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine.
I had to get real persuasive with the Jersey Devil down at the Lucky Pawn. He told me that the Crooked Man's door, to wherever it is he hangs his hat, it moves. It's some kind of magic door.
Do you think the mirror will be able to find the door, once it's fixed?
That's how Crane did it. That's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Unbelievable.
Don't worry. We'll talk soon. You can count on it.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
I found it in Crane's coat. Last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. Well, how would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help. It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fabletown.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Buffkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
Do you need some help over there?
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So just break the news and be done with it, okay? No budge on that bloody glamour. I only came
in to see. Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallop because of you.
I'm starting to think you don't take me seriously, Toad. How many times have I told you to get glamored up? You know that if you're out of glamour, I gotta send you to the farm.
Well, how about your friend the pig, hmm? Is he going to the farm, too? Yeah, you thought we didn't know about him, huh? A worst-kept secret in Fable Town. For a friend, the rules will bend. That's a slippery slope, that is.
If we kill the Crooked Man before his trial...
Oh, I see I've given you something to think about. Now let me add another log to that fire. If you give me one more chance and hear me out, I'll see a way for me and me boy to stay. I'm not gonna ask for any more than I need. I just want to stay. So what do you say? You just give me enough to cover me glamours and we'll call the rest to watch. Please, Sheriff, don't take TJ from the only home he knows. This old glamour rule is oppressive. I've done nothing wrong but look different.
Look, I'll try to get you that money and get you another chance, but you have to understand, that's not entirely up to me.
Oh, thank you, Sheriff. I knew I could count on you to make me whole again. We get you sorted, and I'll be glamour to the nines, I will.
Bluebeard, you want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Toad won't be a problem. I'll see to that.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy. Fine. We'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened to Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons.
If there's one thing I've figured out, it's that the Crooked Man is all about control. It's what he does with the loans at the pawn shop, the magic he peddles, chains,
ribbons. Maybe Faith and Lily weren't doing what they were told. Or maybe they just tried to leave.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
I have to say I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry. I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
He's probably still waking up a little.
Yeah. I want to see where he's ended up, too.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction and looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Mirror, mirror, no time to pout. So, where does Crooked Man hang out? I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
The door. It moves.
What'd I tell you?
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. We can't just dispense street justice. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way, but we have to make a commitment to working within the law.
I'll catch him and bring him back here. Alive. Then we can clean him and cook him together.
Good. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice. Tim, what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny. I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal. I know you aren't here on a social call.
Hold on. You've just been waiting for me to show up? You knew I was coming?
That's what they told me. I don't know, they said you made it pretty clear. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do. Please don't make this hard on me.
Fine, lead on.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard, or an escort for that matter.
You shouldn't be here, Tim. This place is dangerous, especially for someone like you.
It's not like that. Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good. So I hope you two can come to an understanding. A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war. Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Thanks.
Am I some kind of fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah? Mate.
Tell me who the fuck is back there.
It's the wolf.
I don't exactly know. I just mind the door.
He'll come
the boss is there.
And like Crane before him, I'm sure he will prove himself quite handy to have in my pocket. Either he's smart enough to see this is for the best, or dim enough to do as he's told.
I say he'd be more useful killed, skinned, and made into a rug for me to wipe my shoes off. He's right. He was...
That won't be necessary. Sheriff Wolf, sir.
Thank you, Tim. I know the sheriff isn't the accommodating sort, but you handled it. You did well. You can go now.
Thank you, sir.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
It's over. You're alive. You're coming with me.
I've heard stories about you. In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.
That very naughty, dirty girl.
All right, so... Yeah, pretty good. Pretty good percentages. Well, all right then. So it seems like I did a little bit better on this playthrough in terms of getting the better, more wholesome choices. Yeah, you know, they bullies make these games rough in order to figure out which one is the right one and which one is the wrong bad choice, I guess you would call it, to go with. But in the end, they're going to drive the storyline however they see fit, unless they have two big endings for this next episode to come out. I could see them always having the same thing. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and catch you on the next episode. Laters.